it for Jocelyn Chia, everybody.
Hey, everybody. I'm from Singapore. I was given a Chinese name, Di Zi. I asked my dad what it meant, and he said, oh, your name means needs to be hardworking. Wow, what does my sister's name mean? Oh, her name means great beauty. I'm your firstborn child and she gets great beauty? Can we go back to the good old days where the second daughter gets abandoned? And do you really take your firstborn child into your arms, gaze upon my baby face, and say, yeah, let's save great beauty for our second child? This one looks like she's gotta work hard. And my dad was like, oh, calm down. It's better to be hardworking than pretty. Really? Don't know any guys to go around saying, hey, you know what kind of chicks I like? Those are really great. Oh yeah, work ethic. Yeah, check out that chick I got with last night. Employee of the month. Dude, last night we had a three-way conference call. But I actually quit my job to pursue my dream of being a comedian. Oh, thank you. And now that I'm living my dream, I dream of getting a job. All of you with jobs, if you get hit by a car, you have health insurance. If I get hit by a car, I hope I die. I had to go to the doctor the other day. The nurse asked me, oh, what insurance do you use? Blue Cross? I said, no, fingers crossed. But I feel so bad for my parents because I was a lawyer turned comedian. My sister, accountant, now DJ. And my brother just quit his job to go find himself. My dad was like, when did our kids become white? Asians don't find themselves. We find the square root of pi. I'm trying to date now. This is why I get on a date though. The guy would be like, hey, Jocelyn, just so you know, I'm not looking for a relationship. Just got out of a relationship. But I'd be down for a hookup. Really? That's like going on an interview and saying, just so you know, not looking for a job. I just got out of a job. But I'd be down for a paycheck. My God, I was so sick of this. I started using reverse psychology by being the first to tell men that I wasn't looking for a relationship. Mm-hmm. And guess what? Guys really like that. I once went on an eighth date with this guy. Eighth date when he told me he wasn't looking for a relationship. I was like, too late, you're in a relationship. Tomorrow we're going apple picking. But they say that women tend to go for men who remind us of our dads. I know I do, because my men always tell me how beautiful my sister is. did meet a really rich guy once, so a millionaire. He offered to fly me to Dubai, and he was going to pay for everything. But I had a fight because my inner feminist was like, what? He's going to pay for everything? Does he think he can buy you? And then my inner Kardashian was like, what? He wants to pay for everything? Dubai? No, he buy. When I first came to America for college, first thing I learned, Americans cannot tell Asians apart. Yeah, I learned this because back in college, when I went to the bars with my Asian posse, we could all get in with just one ID. And we used my dad's ID. I was actually born in America before moving back to Singapore, so I am American. Yep, what up, my people? And I'm proud to be American. When I travel to other countries, I'll tell people, yeah, I'm an American. But now that Trump is our president, when I go to other countries, I'll just tell people, ah, watashi wa, ni hao ma, arigato, konnichi wa, ni hao ma. You guys have been so much fun. I'm Jocelyn Chia. Thank you so much. Have a great night. Thank you.